Hey everyone, my name is Hannan and I'm currently in grade 11. And it's true that I have been participating in different public forums, such as modeling information and also debate. And this is just to decrease my barriers on speaking in front of everybody. And because of this, it let me learn something new and carry on that barriers are even though barriers are not easy to break, but if you work hard and if you know how to break, if you know how to... If you know how to break those barriers, it will be easy for you. And I want to thank Dr. Sajid for organizing and hosting this event, because I think this is our very first time speaking in a TED Talk event. I think this will be the moment that we should cherish a lot, because we learn a lot and we gain a lot of information. And before starting to my more information, I'll be talking about what does barrier mean and what does overcome barriers mean. And what should we care about that? For the second, is like how does this apply in life? Third, I'll be giving some real life examples on how people overcome those barriers, and also I'll be giving my own experience on how do I overcome those barriers. And what's more to that, I'll be giving some opinions and some advices on how to overcome those barriers. And last but not least, I'm going to conclude with some final touches to my speeches. And before moving on, I want to ask you just one question. What does life mean? What is the meaning of life? And how do we, because we interpret life in many directions, in different, because people have different opinions on what they think about life. And to me, life has barriers. Barriers has life. Both of them, both this word life and barriers are connected together. And they somehow have this relationship between each other. And to further understand what I'm talking about, I'll be defining what does barrier mean. Barrier is the challenges that we face. There's this wall that are ahead of us and are trying to crush our dreams or trying to pull us back from the start. And for overcoming those barriers is that it's to overcome those challenges, is to break that wall, and that is how you can succeed in life. And one of the major barriers that I think that is pretty common here would probably be setbacks. Setbacks are really the barriers that pulls back down from zero. So it pulls back from the starting point that just begins. And I will also mention the minor barriers, because barriers can be defined in many ways, and it's not only limited to students, but barriers are also happen to different people. What's more to that is that minor barriers is like time barriers, money barriers, or family barriers. That is like the most common thing. Those are the common barriers that we have in nowadays. And like for the next point is that how does barriers, like what are the connections barriers have with life? So I mentioned in the beginning of my speech, I said life and barriers have connections. Both of them are related. Because in life, since we were born, we were gifted this barriers. We were gifted this challenges that we have to face in order to succeed in life. And more to that is that it's not just about crushing a dream, but it's your only way, your only path for people to know how to face those problems and know how to handle the situation. And next, I'll be giving you guys a story about these two famous people that you guys might know or might not. And those two people have solved many barriers, and most of their barriers are the same. So firstly, I'm sorry for taking adjustment idea on Steve Jobs. As you know, Steve Jobs is the creator of the Apple company. He created those gadgets that you use right now, the MacBook, iPhone, and the system that you guys use called Macintosh. And even though you think that because Steve Jobs is talented, he's a genius and he accomplished many things since he was young. But for me, there must be something that is holding him back and let him know how to solve the problem that he faced in the future. So one of the problems he faced is that at one time, when after he created the Apple company, he got fired from his own company. And you guys might think that I'm lying, but it's actually a true story. And I'm sure the information I found was true. And after he got fired, he didn't really sit down. He didn't really give up on the objective that he has. Because he has talent. He knows what he's doing. He is very talented with technology and stuff. And that's where he created more companies rather than Apple, which I barely identified. But the point is that he didn't give up. He found other ways to succeed. And he also worked hard on finding those pathways. And on the other hand, for the other person, the famous person that I'm going to mention is called Mark Cuban. And you guys might not know him. He works at a bank for 22 years, and then one time he actually thought this idea that he wants to show off his entrepreneurial skills to the boss. But he got rejected many times, and at the end got fired. And also similar to Steve Jobs, he didn't really give up. He just moved on and find other moves to do. So he got a job on a PC company, and he got a good study out of it. But at the end, he also he was fired too, for the second time. And then he found other jobs, and he was fired many times in every year. But that didn't stop him, and that helped him to realize the idea of breaking barriers. And the barriers gave him this experience on how should he do it. And that's when he created these other companies, like many of the companies that he owns, like Landmark Theater and some other companies that you guys might know. And he owns more than 3 companies in America, I think. And the point I'm giving you guys this story is that you can't give up. The key to success is not to give up. You need to try to find other ways, other paths, and other alternatives that you guys can find in order to succeed. And that's how both those people try to find other ways, and that's how they succeed. And I know I'm just talking randomly because I'm not really following my script, I'm just improvising. But the point is that barriers are easy to broken if you do more work, you don't give up, and you find a way in order to overcome those walls, those fences. So I want a picture that's a wall, but there are many arrows passing through those walls. That shows that you can pass those walls in many ways, under, through, or even over the walls. And to add my experiences, before I came to CIB for at least 3 years in 2015 when I was in grade 9, and I felt isolated a lot during the years, but that's not the reason that I should give up. I tried many things, and also in grade 10, I joined the debate team, and I went to a lot of competitions and won a lot of awards, which that really helped me break the barrier of speaking, not only speaking in front of everybody here for a thousand people, but also breaking the barrier of nervousness and also some other minor barriers such as time barriers and money barriers. And to understand more what does barrier mean is that like the key to broke those barriers like I said just now is hard work, and you need to believe in yourself and you need to have confidence, like what Jerry said just now in his speech. You need to have self-confidence, you need to believe in yourself, and you need to know how. We don't really know how to overcome this problem, but at least you have the experience to overcome those. And I believe that everyone here have different barriers that they have in life, and I believe that you guys may have overcome those barriers and may not. But that's okay. At least if you try to break those, it will be easier to break those barriers in the future. And to conclude my speech, even though barriers are something dangerous that could destroy us mentally or even physically, or it could just entirely crush our dreams. But to me, like what I told Mr. Jasmine, that I want to pursue in the photography, but I don't even know how, but I just research and do a lot of stuff and try to find the best way, the best path in order to pursue that major. And because of that, I got a lot of experience on how to break those barriers and how to overcome those barriers as well. And some advice that if you guys have any problems with barriers, I recommend you guys to talk to somebody, to your friends, families, or anybody that have experienced barriers before and know how to overcome those barriers. And they'll be happy to tell you guys what are their strategies or their keys to overcome those barriers. Thank you.